Live from Investors Group Field in Winnipeg, this is the 2016 Football Canada Cup. This is the seventh place contest between Manitoba Silver and Team New Brunswick. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Winnipeg. My name is Tom Halleck, along with Manitoba Bison quarterback Teo Dizar on color. Thank you very much for joining us for today's action, the final day of the Football Canada Cup. Right now, we are seeing the introduction of Team New Brunswick. Manitoba Silver to be introduced shortly. Seeing the starting defense introduced for Manitoba Silver.
Number 54, Tyler Troche. Number 49, Barrett Mueller. Number 43, Kieran Ducray. Number 23, Jake Robertson. Number 2, Lake Courtmore. Number 70, Brendan Benny. Number 46, Kenton Bowles. And number 98, Sam Grochuk. That is your Team Manitoba Silver.
Corey Weir, our public address announcer, has just introduced Manitoba Silver.
Please get you to stand and remove your hats for the playing of O Canada. Teams, please face the south end of the field with the flag, please.
There you have the playing of O Canada. And in just a few moments, we will be underway. But first will be the coin toss. Let's introduce the officials to you. The referee is J.P. Chorney. The umpire is Kyle Mekaluk. The head linesman is Eric LeBlanc. The line judge is Mark Schmidtke. The side judge is Adam Lawler, the back judge is Omar Kement, and the field judge is Artis Oleksin.
My name's J.P. Chorney. I'll be the referee for today's game. The rest of the group. Okay, so if you have any questions, bring it to myself as captain and Kyle in the middle, and we'll do our best to get you an answer. It's the last game of the tournament for both your teams. I expect it's going to be well played. to the whistle, and let's have a good game. Who's going to be speaking for your team? And you're going to be speaking?
This is going to be the head, tail, head, tail. What's your call? Tails is called. It is a tail. They have deferred to the second half. Kick, receive, choose an end. Chosen to receive, which end would you like to defend? New Brunswick will receive. Shake hands, have a good game.
So there you have the result of the coin toss. Let's take a quick look at the results in the last game for both teams. Team New Brunswick dropped a 13-0 decision to Manitoba Gold, while Manitoba Silver dropped a 22-15 decision to Team Nova Scotia. It will be Barrett Mueller. It will be Barrett Mueller doing the honors. And we are underway. Kick taken at the 21. Up to the 25, to the 20, and stuck there at the 25.
It's Mullally on the return.
49.
Loden Mullally on the return.
The kicker on the play. He kicks off to number 85, Gloden Mullally.
He'll get a 6-yard return.
He's taken
It'll
down
be
by
first down New Brunswick at their 26.
And number 90.
And it will be number 9, David Patry, in at quarterback for New Brunswick to start. Pitch on first down to Aiden O'Neill. Might have lost a couple of yards on the play. Nice job by Barrett Mueller to get the tackle. Looks like it'll be a loss of 2. Second down and 12 for New Brunswick from their 24. Patry in shotgun. 3 receivers left, 2 to the right, 5 receivers set. In the gun. In the pocket, looking to throw. Pass goes incomplete.
Not on the same page there.
Number 10, Leif Henricks, was the intended receiver. And it'll be third down, and we'll see Louis Auger on the punt. Five seconds into our opening quarter, no score. Good snap. Kick is on the way. Taking that to 37. To the 40, 45.
Brandon Friesen.
To about the 46, Brandon Friesen on the return. He'll give him the 48, so it'll be a return of 11. Manitoba Silver with their first offensive drive of the day. They start at their 48. And it is number 8, Dylan Ford, a quarterback. Ford on 1st and 10, fires complete. That is Stephen Burgess with the catch. He's met right away by number 25, Colin Slay. And for Burgess, that's his 3rd catch of the tournament. That is a 7-yard catch for Stephen Burgess. Manitoba Silver 2nd and 3 from midfield. Ford in shotgun. Play action pass down the middle. Just incomplete.
Heine, the intended receiver.
Zachary Heine, Manitoba Silver's leading receiver heading into this game with 7 grabs for 105 yards so far. So it will be 2-0 for Manitoba Silver from the 55. Robertson back to punt. Well, it is O'Neill with the ball at the 30, 35, 40, 45. Couple of flags down center field and taken out of bounds at the Manitoba Silver 53. It is the punter, Robertson, with the tackle.
Let's see what these penalties are.
Illegal block against New Brunswick.
So that'll send them back.
Legal block, New Brunswick.
That was a nice, 18, very nice return for Aiden O'Neill.
First down.
So New Brunswick starts this drive at their 30. We're still scoreless, 2:49 into the opening quarter. Patrick in shotgun. 5 receiver set. In the gun. Fakes to draw to O'Neill. Goes up the middle. He'll get to about the 33. That'll be a gain of 3. Second and 7 for New Brunswick at their 33. Patrick with 3 receivers to his right this time. Back to throw. Complete.
Drop.
Pass goes incomplete. Through the midst of O'Neill.
Nope, that's
Joel
Shaw.
That Joel Shaw. So it's 2 and out for New Brunswick. They'll be 3rd and 3 at their 33. And back to receive the punt are the usual suspects for Manitoba Silver. Dunlop and
Friesen. I think they've been doing that the whole tournament.
High snap to Ogier, fields it. Punt on the way. Bounce back to the 55, flag is down.
Friesen
dives on it. At the New Brunswick 53, let's see what the flag is here.
Brandon Friesen.
Brandon Friesen, the Portage Collegiate Trojan. From the beautiful town of Portage La Prairie. No yards flag against New Brunswick. Yep. See two pieces of laundry on the field. I imagine they're both, they are for the same call.
There are two fouls on the play.
Oh, I was wrong.
No yards, New Brunswick, 16. That penalty is declined. Holding, New Brunswick, number 20, 10 yards, first down.
So Manitoba Silver will operate from the New Brunswick 45. Ford and shotgun with the two back set. Ford was thrown for 225 yards coming into today's game. That is 25. Sakina Scheibler with the ball, I believe. Yes, it is. He'll get the first down. So that's a gain of 17 for Sakina Scheibler. Manitoba first down. Manitoba Silver first down at the New Brunswick 28. Two backs behind Ford. Ford throws. Just about intercepted there. On the coverage for New Brunswick, that was Drew Guimond. Second down, Manitoba Silver from the New Brunswick 28. Ford's pass goes incomplete.
Hey, out of B-Rose, out of B-Rose.
Braden Prochnicki, the intended target. So it'll be Manitoba Silver third down from the New Brunswick 28. It will be Barrett Mueller on to try a 36-yard field goal. Snap is good. Mueller puts the boot on the ball. It is good.
Nice kick.
Barrett Mueller with a 36-yard field goal to put Manitoba Silver on the board first. They lead it 3-0. 5-10 gone in our opening quarter. You're watching the seventh place game in the 2016 Football Canada Cup on footballcanada.com. I'm Tom Halleck, along with Manitoba Bison quarterback Teo Dizar on color today. Here we see Barrett Mueller, a Linden Christian wing. He goes to Linden Christian High School here in Winnipeg. Mueller has the ball teed up on the 45. Kick is away. Taking it to 15 by Mullally, who gets to the 30, the 35. And no further. As it is 43 on the tackle for Manitoba Silver. Kieran Dacre. Flag is down though. And that penalty hurts. Good return. They would have had the ball at about the 35 or so. New Brunswick first and 10 at their 22. Patry still in the quarterback. There's a give to O'Neill up the middle. He gets to the 30.
Circus.
Liam Puskas with the tackle.
Nice tackle by Liam Puskas.
Circus.
Gain of 7. It's second and 3 for New Brunswick from their 30. Just about halfway through our opening quarter. Manitoba Silver in the lead by 3-0. On second and 3.
He stopped
short.
That is
Dylan Waugh.
Looks like he stopped short.
I don't think he even got a yard. On the tackle for Manitoba, looks like Liam Puskas once again.
Echo it so they know on the field.
Measurement requested by our referee, J.P. Chorney. So it is third down and just the nose of the ball to go.
Let's go! Let's
so as far as quarterback sneaks go, this might be the easiest in Mr. Patry's career.
Pretty close.
Though I'm sure in your case, Teo, you'd love about 100 of them just like that.
And he's
Patry
got
goes straight ahead. He gets a little bit extra room.
Nice little game.
He'll get down to the 45. Good gain as he found the hole. Liam Puskas came up with the tackle. When was the last time you saw a quarterback get 10 on a quarterback sneak? It's been a while, I imagine.
Yeah.
First down for New Brunswick at their 43.
Got lucky there, just kind of bounced off and
bounce off, and when you find space, you go.
Hits his running back,
and down goes Patry at his 36. And with the sack, that is Matthew Blake. Matthew Blake, a product of Thunder Bay's St. Patrick High School. Loss of 6 on the sack, as we just heard our public address announcer Corey Weir mention. Second down from the 37. Patry in shotgun, rolls right, flag is down. Pass is complete to the 50. With the catch, that is Leif Henricks. Close to the first down, but the flag is at the 34. Looks like the flag is situated. I was about to say the flag is situated in holding country, but it looks like we have an unnecessary roughness call here. And let's get the call momentarily from referee J.P. Chorney. Talking things over with the Manitoba Silver coach. Mr. Chorney, the floor is yours.
Unnecessary roughness. Delayed knee block. New Brunswick, 56. 15 yards from the end of the play. Third down.
So the ball will go back to the 33. And Louis Auger will be back on the punt for New Brunswick, trailing by 3. Friesen and Dunlop back to return the punt. Ball spotted at the 35. So it's third down and 18 for New Brunswick. Snap to OJ. Ball is away. Looks like it floats toward Friesen, but it will go out of bounds at the Manitoba Silver 43, so they'll start from the 43 on this drive with 3:51 remaining in the quarter. There you see Zachary Heine leading the charge. First and 10, Manitoba Silver at their 43 with a 3-point lead. 3:51 remaining in the first quarter. Takes a snap. I think it'll be freezing to the to about the 50. Aaron Rose with the tackle. It's a gain of 7 for Brandon Friesen. Manitoba Silver second and 3 at their 50. Ford goes shovel pass to Friesen up the gut. It gets to the 54, to the 55.
That's a first down.
That will be a first down. Aaron Rose once again with the stop. Manitoba Silver first down from the 55.
Brandon Whitecrow in at quarterback.
His first action of the tournament. And Whitecrow goes right.
Takes
pass
a shot.
Pass intended for Denoyer goes incomplete. Drew Guimond was on the coverage for New Brunswick. It will be second down from the 55. Whitecrow with the give. Let's see who's got it. Nicholas Cole with the carry. He got to the 50-yard line. So it'll be third and 5 for Manitoba Silver from the New Brunswick 50. It'll be Mueller back to punt and Aiden O'Neill on the return. 1:50 and counting remaining in the first quarter. Good snap back to Mueller.
Flag in the air.
And the ball will go out of bounds inside the New Brunswick 30. And that flag flew as the snap came in to Mueller. Second offside penalty. Illegal procedure, Manitoba Silver.
No end.
No end is a no-no. First down from New Brunswick at their 30-yard line with 99 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Patry in the quarterback. Gives to O'Neill. He gets to the 30, 35, 40. And down to the 44.
Nice gain.
That is 12. Jake Robertson with the tackle. Gain of 13. It'll be first down for New Brunswick at their 43. Pitch to O'Neill. O'Neill gets away from one tackle to the 50. He'll get to the 55 inside Manitoba Silver territory to the 53. And that is Kieran Dacre with the stop. And that'll move the chains again.
Almost brought down by Lake Courtney Moore.
Lake Courtney Moore with the stop, yep. Or with a hand in there anyway.
In the back, he had him in the backfield and he just got away.
First down, New Brunswick at the Manitoba Silver, 54.
What does he do that for? That's almost a procedure. Like, uses his line.
Give to O'Neill to the 45. He'll get to the 40 inside the 35. He'll step out of bounds. Daniel Romeo chased O'Neill out of bounds. We have an injured player down on the field. Let's see if we can get a look. Trying to get a look at the injured player. First down for New Brunswick from the Manitoba Silver 39. 13 seconds to go in the quarter. Patrick with the pitch to O'Neill to the 40, 35, 30. Another first down for New Brunswick. He'll get down to about the 20.
Now with three runs in a row.
They'll have him O'Neill down to the 21. And when things are going good, keep running the guy. Run him till he drops. And that is the end of the first quarter here in the seventh place game here at the Football Canada Cup. After 12 minutes, it is Manitoba Silver 3, New Brunswick no score. You're watching the 2016 Football Canada Cup from Investors Group Field on footballcanada.com. We start the second quarter. New Brunswick first down at the Manitoba Silver 21.
Mullally.
Shovel to Mullally. He'll get to the 20, to about the 15. Hauled down at the 16. Looks like Barrett Mueller got in on the stop.
Late flag on the play.
So it's a gain of 6 pending penalty. Unnecessary roughness against New Brunswick, and in that area of the field, that kind of penalty is going to hurt. Did I hear a hi-ho Silver in the crowd?
I think you may have.
The Lone Ranger rides again at Investors Group Field. We just got to find the horse. They have the ball spotted at about the 30. They have the ball spotted at the 31-yard line. First down and 20. First and 20 for New Brunswick from the Manitoba Silver 31, pardon me.
Five receivers.
And Patry in shotgun. He'll go back to throw, check that. He'll pull it down. He'll get back to the 20 to about the 17.
He made quite a bit of it back.
Matthew Blake with the tackle. Looks like he got 14 of that back.
They'll keep their offense on the field. Third down. Nope.
Actually, that will be 12 of that back. It is third down from the Manitoba Silver 19.
Sending out the field goal unit.
It will be Louis Auger on to try a 26-yard field goal to tie the score. Ball's on the way. It is good. So Louis Auger hits on a 26-yard field goal, and we are tied at 3 with 1 minute gone in our second quarter. 26-yard field goal from Louis Auger, and that is New Brunswick's first points of the tournament. And following the field goal, Manitoba Silver will take the ball at their 35. Dylan Ford back in the quarterback for Manitoba Silver. Gives to Friesen on first and 10. He'll get to about the 40-yard line. Hey, check that, that's Nicholas Cull. Looks like the ball came loose, and it is New Brunswick ball inside the Manitoba Silver 40. Hopefully we can get a replay and see who did what to whom. After the turnover, it will be New Brunswick first down at the Manitoba Silver 40, looking to take their first lead of the tournament. Patry in shotgun.
Swing pass
to O'Neill. O'Neill gets back to the 40. He'll get to about the 36. Andrew Flank with the tackle. Andrew Flank from Hammarskjöld High School in Thunder Bay. Gain of about 3, it's 2nd and 7, New Brunswick from the Manitoba Silver 37. Patry with the give to O'Neill. Cut down at the 36 by Barrett Mueller. That was a nice little toe tip trip by Barrett Mueller. O'Neill got to the 35, so it will be 3rd and 5 for New Brunswick from the Manitoba Silver 35, and they will be going for it. Defensive line. Pitch back to O'Neill.
Get up.
He'll get the first down. He'll get to about the Manitoba Silver 28.
Late flag thrown.
Very late flag, yes indeed. First down is negated on the holding penalty.
Punt.
So New Brunswick will send out the punt team.
Follow your keys, play your keys.
So after the turnover, New Brunswick unable to do anything.
Count.
And again, penalties hurt. Line of scrimmage will be the 45 of Manitoba Silver. Ogier back at his own 51 to kick it away. High snap. Ogier brings it down. Punt taken at about the 12. This
That's
is Dunlop. Dunlop has a hole to the 30. Flag down. He'll get to the 35 and he'll be escorted out of bounds. He is escorted out of bounds by 21. Dylan Waugh. Penalty marker at the Manitoba Silver 18. Illegal block territory? Indeed it is.
Three to return. Legal block. Northwestern Ontario, 96. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Half the distance to the goal puts the ball at the Manitoba Silver 9, so Manitoba Silver has a little bit of real estate to cover here. With 8:57 remaining in the first half, we are tied at 3. I'm Tom Halleck, along with Manitoba Bison quarterback Teo Dizar. Thank you very much for joining us on footballcanada.com for the final day of the Football Canada Cup. Forward on first down, pass is knocked. Passes batted and will go down incomplete.
Defense.
It'll be second down for Manitoba Silver from the 9. Ford looking for the play. Gets the play. Second and 10, Manitoba Silver from their 9.
Ball moving 10 yards forward after a penalty.
Unfortunately, we missed a call. So it's first down for Manitoba Silver at their 19. Jordan shotgun fires it incomplete over the head of Stephen Burgess. Penalty flag down at the 29. Might have been contact a little late in coming in.
Unnecessary roughness, New Brunswick 25, 15 yards, first down.
Unnecessary roughness called against New Brunswick. That moves the ball to the 34 of Manitoba Silver.
I guess if you can slow yourself down, you should try to.
Ford is brought down. And there's another flag or two as Ford is sacked by 45, Timothy Crawford, but I think Crawford did a little waggling of the finger. And that's a bit of a no-no. Here's a replay.
That's a great hit.
Just came charging in and boom.
He let him know about it afterwards.
Yeah.
But what a hit.
Keep playing defense.
Crawford. Excellent play.
Textbook hit.
You know, they see the pros do it on TV and it's okay to talk a little bit. But.
Talk a little smack. But at this level, you have to be a little bit careful. Manitoba Silver, second and seven. Ford with the pass. Complete the bird. Pass is incomplete. Burgess almost had his hands on it. Slay was busted up.
Colin Slay
breaking it up. So it'll be third down. Here's a replay.
That's a big hit by Colin Slay.
Big hit at the 44, separating receiver from football. Third down Manitoba Silver at their 37. .751 remaining in the second quarter. We are tied at three. Mueller the punt for Manitoba Silver. O'Neill is back at his 40. High snap. Mueller gets it away.
Barely.
O'Neill at the 41. Backtracks to the 39, to the 45. Has some room. 55, Manitoba Silver, 50, gets by
he
a guy,
could.
45, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, New Brunswick, butthole the phone. We got a penalty marker down at the 38.
We'll see what the call is.
If the return stands, that's a 70-yard return for the touchdown for Aiden O'Neill.
I see two flags now.
Got around Mueller, and he had clear sailing to the end zone.
During the return, legal block, New Brunswick, 16, 10 yards, first down.
The touchdown goes by the boards. And New Brunswick will start. Looks like it'll be at their 42. And it will be at their, or check that, the 41. So we'll put the ball on the 41, first down New Brunswick. Patry in the gun. There's a give to Dylan Wall. He goes up the gut. He gets to about the 51 or 2.
Almost broke one.
Very close to breaking it. Barrett Mueller with the tackle. That's a gain of 9. So it'll be second and short, New Brunswick at their 50. Wow, the call again up the middle. He'll get down inside the 45. He'll be down at the 44. That's another first down for New Brunswick.
Whoa.
Andrew Thorderson with the tackle. Nice run up the gut.
Great job. Great job, Dylan. Great job, Dylan.
Wall with 35 yards on 10 carries coming into today's game. It's O'Neill with the ball now. He'll get to about the 35. 35-36.
Another late flag thrown.
Another late flag, and those penalties, those flags have been killers.
They add up.
To New Brunswick, yes. And it is against New Brunswick.
Unnecessary roughness. New Brunswick, 56. 15 yards from the end of the play. Second down.
Unnecessary roughness call again. That is called shooting yourself in the foot, unfortunately.
Aiden W.
So it is second down and 15 from the Manitoba Silver 50, halfway through the second quarter. Patry with trips to the left. Play is whistled down. Play clock is at 2.
Looks like some confusion for New Brunswick.
Timeout, New Brunswick. As we'll take a look at some of the sponsors who are bringing you the 2016 Football Canada Cup.
Punt alert.
Here we have a look at David Patry, New Brunswick starting quarterback this afternoon. Second down, 15, New Brunswick at the Manitoba Silver 50. Patry back to pass. Screens it to O'Neill. Flag is down. He gets to the 30-yard line, to about the 28.
That was a nice play, well designed.
But we see a penalty flag down in the New Brunswick backfield at the 50. So it'll be second down now and 25 to go. Ball is back into New Brunswick territory. Ball is at their 50. Back to pass. Flushed out. He'll get to the 55 and no more. Barrett Mueller with the stop. So he'll get five of that. Patry will get five of that back. And it'll be third down, New Brunswick. Looks like they'll spot the ball. Ball's on the hash at the 55, so we'll call it the 55. Dunlop and Friesen back to receive the punt from Louis Auger. Good snap. Ball is out. In the direction of Friesen. Friesen picks up at the 27, gets to the 35 and to the 37. So it'll be good position, good field position for Manitoba Silver with 4:56 to go in the half.
They have time. Plenty of time to do some damage on
4:56
offense.
And if you're in your regular position as Manitoba Bison quarterbacks, they go, got 4 minutes, 56 seconds. Got a lot of time. Do some stuff.
Especially before the half, we'd love to score.
Yes. We're tied at 3 with 4:47 to go in the first half. Sweep, here is 85. Nathan Denoye, he'll get to about the 47, close to the first down. And it will be a first down. Jet sweep to the left. And he was tracked down. By 87. Trying to get that for you. First down, Manitoba Silver at their 47. Pass is complete to the 55.
With Brandon Whitecrow with the completion.
Brandon Whitecrow, I thought that was him back in the game quarterback. He completes it to Stephen Burgess. That's his second catch of the day. Stephen Burgess, another product of Hammarskjöld High School in Thunder Bay. Brendan Whitecrow comes from Fort Francis High School. He hails from Mine Center. Manitoba Silver has the ball at the 55. Whitecrow back to throw under pressure, and down he goes.
Whitecrow just needed a split second longer. Like he was looking downfield.
And that is Aiden Steves picking up the quarterback sack. Here's the replay.
Did not see the sack coming.
Good move. Good move by Steves to get around his man to get the sack. Third down, Manitoba Silver from their 48. Barrett Mueller will punt to Aiden O'Neill as we just had the 3-minute warning given to the benches. Good snap. Punt on the way. Looks like it might go out of bounds. O'Neill picks it up at the 25. Cuts left. And he gets up to about the 36. Maybe 37.
Nice little move by O'Neill.
Yes. Cut it wide. Cut it very wide. Here is the replay. Had to back it up to the 25. Found the hole. It was 22, Liam Puskas with the tackle. First down for New Brunswick at their 37, 2:41 to go in the half. Pass from Patry is complete.
That's Mullally.
Gloden Mullally, who is New Brunswick's leading receiver heading into today with 5 catches for 35 yards. I think that's his first catch today. Falls to earth at the 45. 8-yard catch at 2nd and 2. O'Neill up the middle. He gets to the 50. He'll get to the 52. And that'll be another New Brunswick first down. It'll be very interesting to see the halftime numbers when they come into us. First down, New Brunswick at their 52. O'Neill on the carry. He's brought down. '96 Patrick Stamp with the tackle. Patrick Stamp, another Hammarskjöld High representative. Gain of 2 for O'Neill on first down. It'll be 2nd and 8 from the 54. Under 2 minutes to go in the first half. We are tied at 3. Back to throw. Patry going up high, climbing the ladder, but the pass is incomplete.
Looking for Joel Shaw.
That was Joel Shaw climbing the ladder, and looks like we have an injured Manitoba Silver player. He took off his helmet right away. It looks like he took a shot in the head. And the injured Manitoba Silver player is Jake Robertson. 23, if we can get a look. There he is. There's a look at Jake Robertson. And he'll go back to the bench. So it's 3rd and 8 for New Brunswick at their 54. Ogier punts, and that hangs up there, and we'll take a bounce back to about the 48, inside the 50. Let's see where they mark the kick. It'll be the 45-yard line where Manitoba Silver starts. With 99 seconds remaining in the half, we're tied at 3. Ford back in at quarterback for Manitoba Silver. Ford's pass going incomplete.
Good for Heine.
Had two receivers in the vicinity. That was Heine, the intended receiver. Second down for Manitoba Silver at their 45. Ford's pass intended for Alex France at about the Brunswick 40 goes incomplete. So it is 2 and out for Manitoba Silver. They'll punt from their 45 with 91 seconds remaining in the first half. And it will be Aiden O'Neill on the return for New Brunswick. Mueller stands at his 32. O'Neill at his 30. Snap is good. Punt is away. O'Neill picks it up on the run at the 35. Gets to the 40. To the 45. Tries to break it to the 48. And that's as far as he'll go. So that'll be a return of about 13 yards for Aiden O'Neill.
He does a great job of catching it in the air.
And as we saw on a few occasions on Tuesday, you let the ball hit the ground, you take your chances, basically.
You take
big chances.
Could turn a 30-yard punt into a
70-yard thing of magic. Patrick under pressure gets out of the pocket. Rolls out, looking to throw.
Doesn't have anyone.
Just about intercepted.
Dunlop.
Thomas Dunlop just about coming through with the interception. Second down for New Brunswick. From there, 48. With 71 seconds remaining in the first half. Still tied at 3. Patrick rolls to his right with the completion.
No, it was dropped. Oh.
The pass is incomplete. Looking for number 8, Jason Cowperthwaite. So that is 2 and out for New Brunswick. Here's the look at it again. Good coverage on the play. by Matthew Blake. 106 to go in the quarter. OJ stands as 35 to punt. Dunlop and Friesen back for Manitoba Silver. Perfect snap. Ball is on the way. And that is Dunlop. Dunlop finds a little bit of space. He'll get down to the 46.
Caught by Crawford.
Timothy Crawford with the stop. Yard punt and a 21 yard return. It'll be first down for Manitoba Silver with 54 seconds to go in the half. Ford and shotgun, looking left, has a receiver's got it to the 15, the 10, the 5, touchdown Manitoba Silver.
Braden Prochnicki. I see two flags on the field.
64-yard touchdown reception, but we got to see what the flags mean. Just nicely behind his man, Cameron Wortman. And to the end zone went Mr. Prochnicki. However, let us see what J.P. Torney, our referee, has to say.
Before the touchdown was scored, unnecessary roughness, Northwestern Ontario 66. 15 yards from where the ball was held, first down.
So we've had a touchdown for either side taken off the board due to a penalty.
Fans, just a reminder.
New Brunswick on a punt return, and just now for Manitoba Silver on the Prochnicki touchdown. That would have been a 64-yard touchdown. It's a first down for Manitoba Silver at the New Brunswick 18. Ford back to throw. Looks for a receiver. Tries to find Burgess at the 10. Pass goes incomplete.
Right before the end of the half, that penalty might prove costly. Let's see if they can score.
Second down for Manitoba Silver from the New Brunswick 18. There was almost a costly penalty in the Bomber game last night as Kevin Fogg took a punt back for the touchdown. However, the touchdown was called back because of a hands to the face call, which to my point of view was rather chintzy, but that's just one play-by-play guy's opinion.
And they lost. And I'm assuming you're a fan.
Big one. And you assume correctly, sir.
The bias.
Yes. I bleed blue and gold. Sorry, folks.
Too high safety for New Brunswick. Tipped at the
pass
line.
Pass is tipped. Looks like that was number 80 with the tip for New Brunswick. That's Hunter Levi.
Dylan Ford disappointed.
So it'll be two and out, or check that, third down for Manitoba Silver from the 18. Here's a replay. Yes, it was Hunter Levi batting the pass down. Third down for Manitoba Silver from the 18. This will be a 25-yard field goal try for Barrett Mueller. Kick is on the way. It is... good. So Manitoba Silver with 32 seconds left in the first half takes the lead for the second time today. It's Manitoba Silver 6, New Brunswick 3. New Brunswick will ask Manitoba Silver to kick it off. The ball is on the 45-yard line, where it'll be Barrett Mueller to kick it off momentarily. My name's Tom Halleck, along with Manitoba Bison quarterback Teo Dizar. Thank you very much for joining us today on footballcanada.com for the seventh place game here at the Football Canada Cup. Coming your way at 2 o'clock will be the game for fifth place between Team Nova Scotia and Manitoba Gold. Manitoba Gold getting into the win column with a 13-0 shutout over New Brunswick on Thursday morning, while Nova Scotia held off a determined Manitoba Silver squad 22-15. Mueller with the squib kick that goes to the 35.
That's
the
big
41.
Richard Tier,
99 on the return. He'll get to the 46, so that's about an 11-yard return. That's not bad. When you give the big boy the ball, he's a happy boy. Liam Puskas with the tackle. So New Brunswick has good field position at the 46 and 25 seconds to work with here. Packard the pass, looking for Mullally at the Manitoba Silver 50.
Almost had him.
Pass goes in and out of his hands, incomplete. 4 seconds goes off the clock on that play, 21 to go. Patry looks for the play, gets it. It's in the shotgun. Two receivers on either side. Now three to the right. Patry fires, in and out of the hands of Joel Shaw at the 50-yard line. So once again, it'll be two and out for New Brunswick. With 17 seconds remaining in the first half. OJ back to punt again. So we see the replay here. So OJ back to his 33. Dunlop and Friesen back. Snap goes amiss as a flag is thrown.
Almost a lucky flag.
Almost.
Well, the snap didn't make it back to the punter.
Right. You can scratch almost out of the equation.
Yeah.
So the ball goes back 5 to the 41. And Ogier will be standing at his 27 with 16 seconds remaining in the quarter. So we'll throw another second on the clock. It'll be 17 seconds to go now. Very polite referees in this country. Except in the pile, maybe. Ogier with the punt.
That's Dunlop.
Dunlop on the run at the 38. He'll get to 47, where he'll tiptoe out of bounds.
Flag thrown.
Flag thrown, and Manitoba Silver will have 8 seconds left to work with. Penalty flag pitched in error. So Manitoba Silver will have the ball at their 47 and have 10 seconds to work with here. Time for about two plays.
Do they try and get into field goal range? Or they're just going for the score. No?
I'd say load it up and go long.
Yeah. See what you can get.
At least give it a try. Forward and shotgun. Fires down the middle of the field.
Has a receiver.
In and out of the hands of Alex France. Colin Slay on the coverage. Looks like he might have lost it coming into the sun.
New Brunswick subbing O'Neill onto the field for defense. Putting their best athletes.
The field is now partly in shadow. When we got started this morning, half the field was in shadow. Second down from the 47. Ford looking to launch it. It is complete to Heine at the 41.
Ball's knocked out.
Ball's picked up by New Brunswick. And with the recovery, that was Cameron Wortman. Nice lob pass. Fumble is forced. It is picked up by Wortman, who got to the 52-53. So we are at halftime here at Investors Group Field in the seventh place game. At halftime, it is Manitoba Silver 6, New Brunswick 3. You're watching the 2016 Football Canada Cup from Investors Group Field in Winnipeg on footballcanada.com.
The CFL and our partners at Football Canada want to make sure we keep growing, promoting, and investing in a safe game.
Hit!
Football Canada now requires all amateur coaches to be safe contact trained by 2017. By creating a standard of safety for all in our football community, we're making an already great game even better. Make sure your youth coach is safe contact trained, because making a safe game means making a better game.
Providing fun, inclusive, engaging, and competitive Canadian football experiences begins with great coaching. It all begins with the National Coaches Certification Program, developed by Football Canada, the national governing body of amateur football, in partnership with the Coaching Association of Canada. Football Canada's NCCP provides training for coaches across the country as they progress from playground to stadium, in flag, touch, and tackle. Whether you're a football coach just starting out or a seasoned veteran looking for an edge, this program has a training pathway just for you. Through training, coaches learn how to provide a safe and fun football environment while developing future generations of Canadians. To learn more about the opportunities available, please visit www.footballcanada.com or contact your provincial football association. Providing fun, inclusive, engaging, and competitive Canadian football experiences begins with great coaching. It all begins with the National Coaches Certification Program, developed by Football Canada, the national governing body of amateur football, in partnership with the Coaching Association of Canada. Football Canada's NCCP provides training for coaches across the country as they progress from playground to stadium, in flag, touch, and tackle. Whether you're a football coach just starting out or a seasoned veteran looking for an edge, this program has a training pathway just for you. Through training, coaches learn how to provide a safe and fun football environment while developing future generations of Canadians. To learn more about the opportunities available, please visit www.footballcanada.com or contact your provincial football association.
We are back at Investors Group Field. We are back at Investors Group Field for the second half of the seventh place game. Kick goes down to the Manitoba 10. Reason on the return to the 30, over the 40 to the 42, where Manitoba Silver will start first and 10.
That's a big return.
Up by 3, 6-3.
Yeah.
Manitoba Silver first and 10 at their 41. Dylan Ford still in at quarterback.
Four receivers.
Back to throw. Fires right, ball hangs up. Pass is incomplete at the New Brunswick 50.
Almost looked like it was deflected.
Zachary Heinen, the intended receiver. Got word we had a little bit of technical difficulties in the first half. I've been told the problems are rectified, so thank you very much for staying with us. Thank you very much for your patience. We are back on footballcanada.com. Second and 10 for Manitoba Silver at their 41. Give is to 33, Brandon Friesen. He'll get to the 47. And it'll be two and out for Manitoba Silver to start the second half. Mueller back to punt from his 33. O'Neill lets it bounce, picks it up at the 31. Tries to find the hole, goes wide, and is hauled down.
That's Lake.
Lake Court Moore with the stop. Here are the first half statistics. First downs, Manitoba Silver. Actually, both teams had 8 first downs. I'll pass them along as we go along here. First down, New Brunswick at their 33. O'Neill, the ball carrier, to the 39.
Follows his blocker.
To the 45, rather. So that'll be a gain of 13. Both teams at 8 first downs in the opening half. Let's take a look at the O'Neill run.
Mullally.
Pass complete to Mullally to the 50. Called down at the 53. Close to another first down. Jake Robertson with the stop. Looked like Robertson might have suffered a little bit of an injury late in the half, but he's back. 8-yard catch. It'll be second and 2 from the 53. And that is Dylan Wall with the ball.
Almost couldn't believe how much free room he had to run with.
He is met by Andrew Thorderson. Give the wall up to get. He'll get the first down to the 15. He's down inside the 10. He's down at the 8 or 9. So that is a huge run and a huge first down for New Brunswick.
Right up the gut.
That's a 39-yard run for Evan Waugh.
Subbed up for O'Neill. Let him catch his breath.
Or check that 37-yard run. It's first and 10, New Brunswick, from the Manitoba Silver 11.
Gives to O'Neill.
Patrick gives to O'Neill. O'Neill to the 5, to the 4.
You go line.
And with the tackle, Patrick Stamp, that's his second tackle of the day. Second and 3, New Brunswick from the Manitoba Silver 4, looking to take the lead for the first time today. Give the wall up the middle, gets down to the 1.
Is that a first
Mueller
down?
Mueller with the tackle, pretty close to a first down. He should have it.
Regular, regular.
If he doesn't.
New Brunswick subbing in some bigger
bodies. They mark it third down.
Putting in some bigger bodies is New Brunswick.
They mark it third down, so it'll be third down about a foot. Patrick behind center. Give to Waugh. And it is a touchdown for New Brunswick. Dylan Waugh up the middle, and New Brunswick takes the lead at 9-6. Simple give, and in he goes. For the score, Dylan Waugh, the product of Riverview High School. Scores New Brunswick's first touchdown of the Football Canada Cup. Ogier adds the convert, and is now New Brunswick 10, Manitoba Silver 6.
Late flag thrown.
Very late flag thrown.
Offside called against Ontario, Northwest Ontario.
Manitoba Silver.
Of course.
I think you and Mr. Chorney are on the same wavelength today.
Well, their jerseys say Northwest Ontario, but
yes,
on paper they're Manitoba Silver.
/ NWO.
NWO.
And I don't know if our esteemed color commentator is that much of a wrestling fan. And it would go back way back to about the late 90s, early 2000s.
Here we go.
Okay, thanks for the warning. Right over your head, probably. Oh, well.
Where are we going with this?
There is a faction called the New World Order in WCW. Hulk Hogan, Scott Hall, and Kevin Nash.
Heard of that.
Ogier with the kick, and we are back underway. Kick.
And what a boot.
It is taken by Dunlop about 15 yards in the end zone. Will he get out of the end zone? No, he won't. It'll be a single point. One of the Brunswick players was indicating safety, but
he did not
get out of the end zone. So the New Brunswick lead is now 5 at 11-6. It was like Timothy Crawford.
Thomas. What's important is getting it to the run-in.
So Manitoba Silver trailing by 5 now, starts at their 35. Looking to take back the lead.
Too late, going too late.
Still in the quarterback. First and 10, gives it to Nicholas. 25, Sakina Scheidler on the run, couple of flags down. One at the 32, the other at the 48.
Looked like a New Brunswick player was trying to run off the field.
Did he get off before the gates were closed, though?
They have had too many men.
Referee J.P. Chorney in conference. That appears to be a too many men signal, but we will see for sure.
Legal substitution.
Legal substitution.
10 yards.
Well, there we go.
So Manitoba Silver gets a first down. They are first and 10 at their 45, down by 5. Just about 5 minutes gone in our third quarter. Ford back to throw.
That Heine.
It is complete to Heine. He has it at the 55. And on the tackle is number 20, Aaron Rose, and Rose is injured at the 55. There have been three New Brunswick players who have gone on, who have played in the Football Canada Cup. Josh Sacobi was a quarterback. He went on to the University of Ottawa GGs, played in the Canada Cup in 2011 and 2012, and went on to the 2011 senior national team. Dan McCullough went on to be an O-lineman at Bishops with the Gators, also played in 2011 and 2012, and went on to play with the BC Lions, where he enjoyed a four-year career. And Jeremy Steves was a defensive back at St. FX. He played in the 2011 Canada Cup. Steves went on to be an All-Canadian at St. FX. Sacobi went to the University of Ottawa, was a two-time CIS All-Canadian. As we said, was a member of the senior national team in 2011. Aaron Rowe is now leaving the field. Total offense in the opening half as we go back to the numbers here. New Brunswick with 138 yards of offense to Manitoba Silver 101. Sakina Scheibler was the leading rusher for Manitoba Silver in the first half. Two carries for 22 yards, one of 17. Aiden O'Neill ran the ball eight times for 70 yards. As far as the passing department goes, Patry has gone two of eight for 11 yards. Ford is three of 13 for 52. First down, Manitoba Silver, or check that, second and one from the 55. Close to the first down. Nicholas Cull on the carry.
Looks like they got it.
They'll give him the first down at the 55, poking the 54. I do believe. Inside the 55. So first down, Manitoba Silver.
Ooh.
Mix up in the line. Mix up in the backfield.
It's Alex France with the ball.
Alex France with the ball on sweep, and that play went the wrong way.
Kind of
Aiden Steves had the tackle there.
I think they were coming from both directions. Both thought they were getting the ball.
Loss of two on the run at second and 12. The ball on the Manitoba Silver side of the field, this time at the 53. Pass complete to Hyena. Got to the 51, brought down at the 52. They'll spot the ball at the 51. So it'll be third down for Manitoba Silver from the New Brunswick 51, trailing by five, with 5:06 remaining in the third quarter. New Brunswick up by five at 11-6. Barrett Mueller back to punt. They have an onside man.
He will be going for it.
Mueller's put off the side of the foot and out of bounds. It will go.
Good idea. He was there. Close. But just out of bounds.
But close only counts in horseshoes, so they say. So New Brunswick starts an excellent field position for them at their 44. So what do you expect? A little more grinding along the ground, courtesy of Mr. O'Neill. Looks like it's
Mulally. Finds a seam.
Gloden Mulally. He'll get to the 50. That's a good gain of six on first down. Quick pitch. New Brunswick second and four at their 50. Patry in the gun gives to O'Neill. He'll get to the 55. Bounce off a man, get to the Manitoba Silver 50, and down he'll go there.
Nice first down.
Number 40, Carl Loeffler with the stop.
You say Loeffler?
Loeffler, Robertson also in. Let's see on the replay. Check that. Loeffler was in the neighborhood but didn't make the tackle. First down at the 50. Patrick calls his own number. Get close to the 40. Should be another New Brunswick first down. Patrick Stamp, his third tackle of the afternoon. Gain of 9 for David Patry, second and 1 from the Manitoba Silver 41. It's second and inches. Second down, half a cigar, go. Dylan Waugh with the ball, and he'll get down to the Manitoba Silver 30.
It's an easy game for Waugh.
Very easy game, very easy first down. Very easy first down.
New Brunswick goal line starting to prove a point.
Loeffler with the tackle for Manitoba Silver. First down for New Brunswick at the Manitoba Silver 31. Looking to build on a 5-point lead. New Brunswick up 11-6, pardon me. Dylan Waugh up the middle, and he is going to score. Touchdown, Dylan Waugh. With a 31-yard run for the Nova Scotia touchdown. New Brunswick touchdown to give him a 17-6 lead. Up the middle, and just about untouched. And there is the touchdown. So New Brunswick leads 17-6. With 2:20 remaining in the third quarter. Looks like they'll go for two. Patry with the 2-point try.
It
is intercepted. And play is whistled down. And it looked like Robertson had some designs on getting 2 points for his side. However,
guess that's not how it works.
Doesn't seem to be that way. So the score holds. It's New Brunswick 17, Manitoba Silver 6. There is the man with the touchdown, Dylan Waugh. There's Jake Robertson with the interception on the 2-point try. Here's a replay of the Waugh touchdown.
That was a nice run by Waugh. Keeps his legs pumping. No one can bring him down.
OJ will tee it up at the 45. Ball is on the way. Two freezing at the 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. He'll get to about the 31 or 2.
It's Timothy Crawford with the tackle.
Return of 22 for Brandon Friesen. So Manitoba Silver with 2:15 to go in the third quarter, trailing 17-6, has the ball at their 32.
Let's go, Brad!
Ford with the completion to the 50. That is Alex France with the catch. 18-yard reception for him. First down for Manitoba Silver at their 50. Alex France, who had four catches for 37 yards heading into today's action. It looks like Dylan Whitecrow, or Brandon Whitecrow, in the quarterback for Manitoba Silver, excuse me. Pass is complete into New Brunswick territory to about the 47.
That's Nicholas Cole with the catch.
Nicholas Cole with the catch and another Manitoba Silver first down.
Whitecrow getting the offense moving.
Nice job of threading the needle between the defenders. First down, Manitoba Silver, the ball at the New Brunswick 48, trailing 17-6. As we're in the final minute of the quarter. Under pressure, throws.
Risky play.
Pass goes incomplete, very risky pass. Closest man to it for New Brunswick was 25, Colin Slay. So second and 10 for Manitoba Silver from the New Brunswick 48.
506!
Whitecrow in shotgun. Back to throw under pressure. Gets away from a man. Will fire long. That pass is intercepted. That is Aiden O'Neill with the interception. O'Neill hauled down at the 17, and we have an injured Manitoba Silver player.
Looks like Whitecrow.
Whitecrow.
Whitecrow probably took a shot.
Let's see if we can get a replay of that. Here it is. Yes, just hit as he threw.
His eyes are downfield, but.
And there you see Brandon Whitecrow, the injured Manitoba Silver quarterback. Brandon Whitecrow, as we mentioned, is from Fort Francis High School, calls Mine Center home. There you see the Manitoba Silver defense. And Whitecrow is now up to a seated position. He'll get some help to get off the field. There he is, up, coming off on his own steam. That's a good sign. 12 seconds remaining in the third quarter. New Brunswick with a 17-6 lead. Have the ball at their 20-yard line. Or check that, the 19 ball's very close to the hash on the 20. With the give to Dylan Law. He'll get the first down as Robertson escorts him out of bounds. And that is the end of the third quarter. After three quarters, our score, Team New Brunswick 17, Team Manitoba Silver 6. You are watching the 2016 Football Canada Cup from Investors Group Field in Winnipeg on footballcanada.com. They have just announced an all-points bulletin for the 50-50 winner from this past Saturday. As we start the fourth quarter, here is Patry, the ball carrier. He'll get up to the 45. And that'll be another first down for New Brunswick. First down New Brunswick from the 45 with an 11-point lead. We're just 30 seconds into the fourth quarter. Pitch to Mullally. Mullally gets hauled down at about the 46 or 47. They'll give him the 48 as Thomas Dunlop makes the tackle. Second and 7, New Brunswick. Aiden O'Neill on the carry. Lake Court Moore wraps them up. At the 47, so it doesn't look like O'Neill will gain a yard, so it's third down. Actually, I will give him one. Third down from the 48 for New Brunswick. Louis Auger back to punt. Good snap. Friesen will take it at the 26, gets to the 30. Steps out at the 33, so Manitoba Silver down by 11. We'll start this drive from the 33. Check that. It'll be first down at the 32.
I trust you so much.
So 10:15 remaining in the fourth quarter. Manitoba Silver down by 11. Ford back in at quarterback. Under pressure, rolls to his right, gets away, fires, complete to the 40-yard line.
Wow.
And taken down well out of bounds. That's Stephen Burgess.
Nice job by Ford escaping the pocket, finding a receiver downfield.
So that's an 8-yard catch, or check that, 7-yard catch for Stephen Burgess. It's second and 3 for Manitoba Silver from their 39. Ford under pressure fires.
That's Hina.
Complete to Hina. Hina will get to the 51. And another Manitoba Silver first down. First down Manitoba Silver at their 51. Almost 3 minutes gone in the fourth quarter. New Brunswick up by 11, 17-6. Manitoba Silver driving though. Sweep goes a miss. It's whistled down.
I think they're calling it an incomplete pass.
Incomplete pass looked like a jet sweep to me, but it is ruled an incomplete pass. Here it is. Oh, that's right. Shovel pass going to miss. Okay. Shovel pass goes amiss. Second and 10 for Manitoba Silver at their 51. Ford and shotgun.
Just behind.
And And Aiden O'Neill was on coverage for New Brunswick, so it's third down Manitoba Silver from their 51.
Aiden O'Neill playing defense, running back, and returning for New Brunswick today.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a triple threat personified. Third down from the 51, and there we see Mr. O'Neill waiting for the Mueller punt. Robertson's the onside man. O'Neill takes it at the 30, tries to get it on a couple defenders, does, 35.
O'Neill's got it.
He's found the hole, 50, 55, 45, tripped
just
up inside
got
the 40.
That was the kicker.
Barrett Mueller with the touchdown saving tackle. That's a 40-yard return. It's first down New Brunswick from the Manitoba Silver 40. Patry in the gun. Three receivers right.
Joel Shaw.
Joel Shaw on the sweep. Strung out along the 40-yard line. Will get to about the 38, I do believe.
Makes a couple of guys miss.
But a good job by the Manitoba Silver defense to keep him running along the line as Robertson made the tackle. Gain of two. It's second and eight from the Manitoba Silver 38. Play action. It's Patry with the ball. Following Waugh all the way up to the Manitoba Silver 20-yard line.
Patry slicing through the defense.
Slicing like a knife. Slicing like a knife with a serrated edge. Good fake. Good fake, and Patry just followed the opening. Saw the opening and went mine. First down from the Manitoba Silver 20. Patry looking for the end zone.
Has
and it is
and
caught,
caught
for the touchdown. That is Dylan Talbone with the New Brunswick touchdown.
A nice pass
and it is,
catch.
And it is 23-6 for New Brunswick. 20-yard touchdown catch for Dylan Talbone.
It's a perfect spot to throw the ball.
As a quarterback, you gotta love that. You gotta love a pass like that.
Very smooth.
OJ adds the convert as we had a look at the Patry run from the previous play. OJ adds the convert. So with 6:31 remaining in the fourth quarter here in our seventh place game, it is New Brunswick 24 and Manitoba Silver 6. From July 28th to 31st, in preparation for the 2017 IFAF Senior World Championship, Football Canada hosts the inaugural Senior Women's Tackle Football Championship in Regina. Teams from Alberta, Saskatchewan, Quebec, and New Brunswick are taking part. We are back to play. Kick is taken in the end zone.
Dunlop's going to take
Dunlop. Dunlop to the 5, the 10, the 15. Gets to about the 19, maybe the 20. So Dunlop, who took that kick about 10 yards in to his end zone, comes through with a nice return. He'll get to the about the 20-yard line, so. And that's where they should spot the ball. Front foot of the official is on the 20, on the hash. Oh, there was a penalty flag. There it was. There it is.
Northwestern Ontario, 48. Ball be placed at the 1-yard line. First down.
So Manitoba Silver has a whole lot of real estate to cover. And time is not on their side. 6:22 remaining. Pass complete to the 8-yard line. Ford connects with Stephen Burgess. Keegan Waters with the tackle after a 8-yard catch. Manitoba Silver second and 2 from the 9. Shotgun fires down the side, fires
that's
down
Alex
the
middle
of the field. Alex France to the 27,
nice.
And that's an 18-yard catch and a Manitoba Silver first down.
Now they're out of their zone, just like that.
Out of the shadow of the goalposts in just 2 plays. So Manitoba Silver with a little bit of breathing room at their 27, with 5:17 to go. Ford down is brought down. That is Brendan Seymour with the sack, number 68.
Late flag throw.
Very late flag as the Leo Hayes High School product records the sack. Penalty after the play.
Objectionable conduct called on Zachary Cormier.
Objectionable conduct.
Not quite sure what he did, but disagreed upon by the officials.
I wasn't sure what was happening on that either.
5 receivers.
On second and 2.
Outside, Tahina off his fingers.
So it'll be 3rd and 2 for Manitoba Silver, down 24-6. Third and 2, and it is 3 down territory for the rest of the way for Manitoba Silver.
Most definitely.
That would probably be the understatement of the day. There's the pitch to Cole. Cole will get the first down. He'll get to the 48 or 49. We'll give him the 48. First down for Manitoba Silver. Colin Slay with the tackle. First down at the 48 with 4:07 to go in the fourth quarter. The Brunswick 24, Manitoba 6. Ford back to throw, fires
that's
down the middle. Nice leaping grab by Zachary Heine. At the 48-1, New Brunswick player signals incomplete.
What a catch by Heine.
Good, excellent job of stretching out as we take a look at the replay. Yep.
That's a catch.
First down, Manitoba Silver from the New Brunswick, 47. Ford's pass goes to the 32-yard line, incomplete. Denoyer, the intended receiver. Penalty flag down. at the 53.
Take a knee.
We have an injured Manitoba Silver player.
Holding. New Brunswick, 90, 10 yards, first down.
Injured Manitoba player, it is number 50, Kyler Hosegood. Hosegood over at the New Brunswick 50-yard line. As his offensive mates talk things over. Mentioning a couple moments ago about the senior women's nationals, Canada's head coach Jeff Yauzi, who serves as the offensive coordinator of these with the Saskatoon Valkyries and has led the squad to five Western Women's Canadian Football League championships in 6 years of the league's existence. Richard, that Yauzi is head coach, pardon me. Did I say offensive coordinator? My apologies. The senior women's tournament let's go back to Kyler Hosegood down at the 50-yard line. As the trainer signals to one of her assistants. And there's Hosegood jumping off the field.
Manitoba Silver with some fortunate field position.
First down at the 37. Ford looking for a receiver at the 30-yard line.
It is a through Ford.
That was Burgess, the intended receiver. Colin Slay on the coverage. As we look at Timothy Crawford. Another injured player on the field. That is Stephen Burgess down at the 35. Take a look at the Manitoba Silver offense. As Stephen Burgess heads off the field. We have 3:10 remaining in the fourth quarter, 3:09 actually. Manitoba Silver down 24-6, second down at the 37. Pass goes incomplete.
Another late flag.
Hits a New Brunswick defender right in the bumper. Samuel Allward got the ball right in the tuchus. One flag down at the New Brunswick 37 and the other at the 46 or 7.
Offside. roughing the passer. 15, 20 yards, first down.
20-yard gain.
So Manitoba Silver picks up 20 yards on the double whammy. And has the ball on the New Brunswick 17 with 2:54 to go. Ford back to pass. Jump ball, it is incomplete. Braden Prochnicki playing jump ball.
Almost had it.
Yeah. Playing jump ball against the New Brunswick defender. Jump ball at the goal line. Out fought Carter McMacken at the goal line, but out jumped him. Second down. There's the get, the Cole. He's over for the touchdown. Nicholas Cole with a 17-yard run for the Manitoba Silver touchdown. So with 2:38 to go, there's still a bit of life in Manitoba Silver. Score is 24-12.
Looks like they're going for the extra point. Or extra 2-point convert, sorry.
To pull within 10.
Making it a field goal and a touchdown away.
Ford with the throw, it's batted down at the line. The score will hold. Now we have a little bit of a difference here. The board you see on your screen reads 23-12. The stadium board reads 24-12. There it is. Thank you, fellas. It is 24-12 for New Brunswick. 2:38 to go. And I wouldn't be surprised to see an onside kickoff coming up.
I think that's what we're expecting.
Mueller with the ball in the tee.
Chips onside. It left.
Yep, chip shot to the left. And ball rolls out of bounds.
Flag
is down, so the kick probably went out of bounds
they
to
give it to New Brunswick.
So New Brunswick sets up shop with 2:36 to play at their 42. Patrick with the pitch to O'Neill. O'Neill goes right. Gets to about the 46. Liam Puskas with the tackle. Give the tackle to Jake Robertson. Gain of 5. Second down at the 46. Patrick in shotgun. Gives to O'Neill. O'Neill trying to find a little bit of room. close to the 50. Joseph Poirier with the tackle. So a two and out for New Brunswick.
Dunlop and Friesen back to return.
The usual suspects, as we've come to know. Ogier back to punt. Kick is away. Dunlop lets the ball roll into the end zone.
Like
he's about 5 yards in. Looks like he might have lost it in the sun. You're right. And down he'll go in the end zone. And that's a single point for New Brunswick.
And more importantly, making it a 17-point game.
13-point game, actually.
Oh, my bad. 13-point game. Still,
no worries.
Still within a... Two scores.
Two scores, 13 points, yes.
13.
Don't feel bad. I took remedial math in high school.
You know, you look at the numbers and they get all jumbled.
Yeah. After you've been staring too long, they do. First down, Manitoba Silver, the ball at their 35. Trailing by 13. They have a minute 56 to go. Ford fires complete on first down. That is Heine. He's down to the 53.
Coming close to that'll breaking
be,
one.
Yep. 18-yard catch for Zachary Heine. First down. They'll give him the 55, so that's a 20-yard catch for Zachary Heine. That play took 11 seconds. Ford back to throw.
Flag thrown.
Flag is down. Pass goes off the mitts of 55, Joseph Richardson from Brunswick. Let's see what the flag is. Hold on.
Legal contact on the receiver. New Brunswick, number 32. 10 yards, first down.
And that will move Manitoba Silver down to the New Brunswick 45. They have 91 seconds left to work with, does Manitoba Silver.
Let's go, whoa!
Ford fires it long down the sidelines. Passes picked off. With the pick, that is 25, Colin Slay, and that should do it. That should put the wraps on this game for New Brunswick.
New Brunswick needing a couple first downs to burn the clock.
So it will be first down New Brunswick at their 30. 80 seconds to go in the game. Waugh in the backfield. Waugh with the ball up the middle. Gets to about the 32. Flag against New Brunswick, Charles Lavallee. Was penalized. 1:14 to go in the fourth quarter. New Brunswick leads 25-12.
Let's go, defense!
First down and 20.
Yeah.
Calls his own number. gets down to about the 28.
Timeout called.
Joseph Poirier.
Manitoba Silver using a timeout.
Poirier with the tackle. Manitoba Silver uses their first timeout of the second half. The 2016 Flag Football National Championships took place from May 18th to 23rd at Dalhousie University in Halifax, featuring under 16 and under 18 male and female divisions, as well as a male under 20 division. In the under 16 female division, Saskatchewan earned a bye to the gold medal game, where they met host Ontario following a 26-7 semifinal win over Ontario. Led by three touchdowns and two interceptions from Kate Thorstedt, Saskatchewan maintained a perfect 5-0 record, winning gold 19-2.
Get him, Drake!
Patrice pass goes incomplete at the 35. Joel Shaw was the intended target.
Eric Moffitt appears to be the shaken up Manitoba Silver player.
And let's see if we can get a shot of that.
Three games in 6 days, is it?
Yes.
Takes a toll on the body. Surprises a lot of these big men are.
That is so true, yes.
As vertical as they are.
It is 75, Eric Moffitt leaving the field. So yet again, the 506 chant comes up. As OJ is back to punt on third down.
Dunlop
will be Dunlop on the run at the 48. He'll get to the 53. Tries to get around the man to the 50. 55. New Brunswick 50 and out of bounds at the 48.
Penalty flag thrown.
Dylan Wall with the tackle.
Looks like unnecessary roughness.
How many of those calls have there been today combined?
Both teams vying for their first victory of the tournament.
And New Brunswick just 51 seconds away.
Necessary offense. Northwestern Ontario 48, 15 yards, first down.
So first down, Manitoba Silver at their 46. Let's see if Dylan Ford can mount one last touchdown drive for his side. Ford back to throw it down the middle of the field. It is complete.
Freezing
all the way down to the 30. Penalty marker down at the Manitoba Silver 47.
That's Timothy Crawford with the tackle.
That's a 34-yard catch for Brandon Friesen.
Down.
Penalty against Brunswick is declined. we have an injured New Brunswick player on the play. Try to get the number for you. Let's see if we can get a closer shot, if we can. Timothy Crawford leaving the field.
A busy day he's had.
Indeed. A nominee for New Brunswick player, defensive player of the game. So first down, Manitoba Silver from the New Brunswick 30. 40 seconds left in the game. Looking down the sideline, that one just about intercepted, but that was captured out of bounds.
Call him out of bounds.
Nice try by Ben George stretching out, but
almost. Caught the ball at the highest point.
And that's the name of the game, correct? That's what the coaches tell you. Ford on second down, pass goes off a hand, and incomplete.
Intended for Heine.
So third down for Manitoba Silver. Down by 13, going 30 seconds ago. It is an obvious gamble. Ford going for the end zone.
Had
it is incomplete. France was the intended target, so that'll be a turnover on downs.
Sandwiched by a couple defenders.
And New Brunswick can just coast it in now. 25 seconds to go with a 13-point lead at 25-12. David Patry in victory formation now. Takes off 2 seconds.
And the coach receives a Gatorade dump.
Yep.
A shower for him.
Time back in.
Nice to see the support of the players and the coaches. That's what it's all about, eh?
Yes.
Having fun.
Yes. David Patry has a look at the clock. Patry will take a knee, and New Brunswick will grab seventh place here at the 2016 Football Canada Cup, recording a 25-12 win over Manitoba Silver. Bunch of New Brunswickers shaking hands with Team Manitoba Silver, and in a few moments we will have the players of the game for both teams. And now the teams will line up along their respective 45-yard lines. .506 is the chant. From a rather happy New Brunswick contingent. There you see. Here's Corey Weir with our players of the game.
Later at Western University, Chris Marcus on the offensive side of the ball. Number 21, Dylan Waugh.
Dylan Waugh, the offensive player of the game for New Brunswick.
And on defense, number 45, Timothy Crawford.
Number 45, Timothy Crawford. With the defensive player of the game award for New Brunswick.
Called his name often today.
Kennebecasis Valley High School in Quipasimus. I hope I got that right.
And presenting for Team Manitoba Silver, head coach at Wilfrid Laurier University, Michael Foles. On offense, number 36, Nicholas Cole.
Nicholas Cole, who scored one of the touchdowns for Manitoba Silver. St. Ignatius High School in Thunder Bay accepting his award from Michael Falls, Wilfrid Laurier head coach, who played
in
CIS
defense,
football
number
at
49,
Western.
Barrett
had a
Mueller.
Very successful career there.
Barrett Mueller is the defensive player of the game for Manitoba Silver.
Michael Folds also being quarterback coach for the East-West All-Star game.
Ladies and gentlemen, one last round of applause for T.T. Brunswick and T.T. Manitoba Silver.
And the awards have been presented. The teams will leave the field. Thanks very much for joining us for the seventh place game here at the 2016 Football Canada Cup. New Brunswick is your winner this afternoon, 25-12 over Manitoba Silver. Don't stray too far. We'll be back at 1:55 Central, 2:55 Eastern with our fifth place game between Team Nova Scotia and Manitoba Gold. For Manitoba Bison quarterback Teo Dizar, I'm Tom Halleck. Thank you very much for joining us today. The final score once again, Team New Brunswick 25, Team Manitoba Silver 12. We'll be back at 1:55 for the fifth place game between New Brunswick or Nova Scotia and Manitoba Gold. We'll see you again at 1:55.